Hey, coming up right now, no need to be naked and afraid. A French museum wants visitors to show their body of work.
Also coming up, that's rude. The top 10 U.S. cities where politeness is in limited supply.
A little bit later on, whoa, Living on a Prayer has a new meaning for one woman after an encounter with John Bon Jovi. We'll tell you about that.
Daily Flash starts right now.
Get ready for trending news and entertainment. This is Daily Flash with your hosts, Andrea Jackson and Mitch English. The fun starts right now. This is Daily Flash.
Hey everyone, I'm Andrea Jackson.
She sure is. I am Mitch English. So glad to have you here. We are welcoming you to Daily Flash, mm-hmm. and so glad that we got this whole hour packed and ready for you as well as the jet setter Matt Doolittle. Matt was up in D.C. Did you change some laws up there, Matty?
I really tried. I just tried to not get in any trouble or end up on CNN. But I did notice a lot of people like to run. A lot up there. They just run. That's all they do. A lot of the people just running. They run from here, they run from there. Sure as hell can't run the country.
They can't run the country, yeah, but they can country. Run.
Okay. And I can tell you something. This is going to make us sound really old. There was a time where, like, the jogging was new back in the 70s. Remember, like, people would jog and I'm like, what are you doing? And now it's just like every day. So when you said running, it's
sitting around where the Washington Monument is and just watching everybody. And I'm just sitting there like, a lot of people just running. I mean, the weather was beautiful for this time of year, but I was just like, I don't think they have anything else to do right now.
Can I tell you something really quick? They had this study at the pedometer, the pedometer.
Yeah.
What's the average number of steps is you're supposed
10,
to take?
10,000.
10,000?
10,000.
You know where that came from?
No.
Why 10,000? Because my 10,000 would probably be different. The amount of steps I need to take would be different than yours.
Okay, sure.
So the only thing they can attribute to the 10,000 is because the Japanese symbol for 10,000, it looks like a guy walking.
Are you serious?
My hand to the heavens.
Oh,
Google
my
this.
Gosh.
It's ultra. That's the only reason it's arbitrarily just 10,000 steps that we're supposed
because
to take.
Because it matched an icon.
Because it matched an icon. And the icon looks like a guy's doing this as well. Google it. Type in Japanese symbol for 10,000. They say that's the only, they're like, we don't know where this, why it was 10,000. No one can tell you. So there you go.
Matty, I did see your picture of the Lincoln Memorial.
Yeah.
Is that not the most astounding thing you've ever seen?
It was amazing. And they got it, especially at night when it's lit up and you can see everything. It was really amazing.
When Matt and I travel a lot, he actually has me doing my Lincoln Memorial. He'll bust open the door in the bathroom, and I'm like,
sadly,
I sit like this.
I have seen that. So.
He has pictures of me doing the Lincoln Memorial.
Mental, trauma, but yeah, mostly. Yeah, well,
I need to see that in a whole montage, I think, of every trip you've ever taken and you in that particular position. Right. Hey, speaking of work, Amazon has now issued a declaration to all of its employees, you are to be back into the office.
Physically.
No more working from home. And they have to make this decision by January 1st. Now, why January? I don't know. Why not
the Japanese
now?
Man.
Or maybe the Japanese calendar, right. The work calendar. Why they are giving people a few months to make that decision, I'm not quite sure. But it seems to be a trend. Everybody is saying it's finally time to get back into the office.
I could kind of agree with it. And first off, they have real estate. There's actual buildings just sitting there. Second thing, I think we tried it. We were all doing our little thing on our own. And I think maybe they saw a little productivity. But I don't know. It just makes sense, especially Google, the ones that come up like Google Meet. Mm-hmm. We never heard about Google Meet until the pandemic. So it's interesting to see that. If we'll see any more progression as well.
You don't realize the amount of other businesses that depend on you being at work, in the workplace, the restaurants, the delis, the cafes, the coffee shops, not to mention the commercial real estate. You're renting that property. You're renting that building. So you're part of this like eco community.
I kind of like it. I kind of like people getting back to work.
My wife works for that big corporation. It has that giant building in Lake Mary.
Three letters.
Yeah, she had me come visit one day, and they've got a beautiful cafe.
Yes.
Beautiful. The building's amazing. Nobody there.
Wow.
And so they're starting to nudge them back to at least 4 days a week.
I think, too, if you're an investor and you walk into a building and it's kind of empty, you're like, what am I buying here? Because I can't really see it. Maybe that could be a reason. I don't, not to say Google's for sale, but other businesses might
be. Sure.
We go over now across the pond to France, where a museum there has announced that it's going to invite its visitors to check out its latest exhibit on nature, but You have to wear nothing but just a pair of shoes. Mm-mm. And that's because of regulation, believe it or not. The it's true. The museum will welcome naked patrons to show off their, quote, body of work on a certain day once a month. However, shoes will be required to avoid splinters and that sort of thing. The new exhibit, it's going to run through December 9th. It features painting, sculptures, photographs, and moving images from nature. And that's, you know, the argument is that's what art is. Art can be anything. And so if you have people that are naked seeing these sort of things, then that's the art.
So that is in itself the art exhibit. You're showing up naked to a nudist art exhibit.
And before everybody gets excited, the people that have no problem getting naked are the people you don't want to see.
Usually that is
the case. And those are the people that might knock something over too.
Yes.
So you got to be careful there. You know, like if Pete Davidson shows up, you might,
Exactly. Exactly.
We'll just leave that right there for you. Miami, known as the Magic City, is losing some of its sparkle, and that's according to the residents who are from there. In the latest study, Florida's hotspot has just named itself one of the rudest cities in the U.S. Residents say they lack self-awareness, they're loud, and many are rude to service workers. A few other dishonorable mentions: they don't respect personal space or hygiene in public and seem to lack any compassion for others. Again, this is all per the Miami residents.
This is what they're saying.
Nearly 90% of residents say they believe people living in downtown Miami are not as nice as those living in the suburbs. Philadelphia, Tampa, and Louisville follow Miami in the rankings for cities with the rudest residents. The study says the nicest residents can be found in Omaha, Minneapolis, and San Diego.
San Diego. I would imagine, much like Miami, though, they'd get more rain, but San Diego is such a great place to live. And, you know, you're from there, and they would always say, well, we pay you in sunshine.
Yes.
And I got so tired of hearing that, but it's a beautiful place. Now, Matt, you love Miami.
Oh, I do not. I have a saying when I take anybody.
This conversation.
I have a saying when I take anybody down there. I go, guys, the minute we get past Fort Lauderdale, nobody cares.
Yeah.
Laws don't apply.
That's a good point.
Nobody cares. Just the nobody knows traffic signs, nothing.
Yeah.
Nobody cares.
Matt and I, we're actually going down there next week too. So
Miami's a lot like Las Vegas, about 3 days max, and that's all you can do. And then it's time to go home.
It seems like traffic in Miami too, because
the traffic lanes don't matter. They just don't. The speed limits don't matter. They have a whole Instagram page to only indade, like that just shows all the accidents and craziness that goes on down there. They have their own Instagram.
I love it.
It's a good follow.
All right, we'll go back up to way up in New Jersey. How about that? Where rocker Jon Bon Jovi recently made some headlines for saving a woman's life. He was out there filming a music video on a bridge in Nashville, actually, when he was noticing that something just didn't seem right. There was a woman who had stepped over the railing and seemed as if she was just about to jump. Look at this. This is the actual video. You can see Jon Bon Jovi approaching her. John and another Good Samaritan pulled the woman back over the railing and embraced her. Jon Bon Jovi actually created the JBJ Soul Foundation way back in 2006 to help provide ways out of homelessness, poverty, and hunger for families all across the United States. Now, if you are struggling, in all seriousness, with any kind of maybe mental health crisis, you can dial the 24/7 National Suicide Prevention Hotline. The number is really easy, 988, or you can go to suicidepreventionlifeline.org. He was in Nashville. He just opened up a new a bar there, actually. There are a lot of entertainers. If you go down Broadway in Nashville, it's everybody, every country star pretty much has one now, Jon Bon Jovi as well. But everything I've heard about John is that he is a real, genuinely good guy. And this proves it, this sort of thing. And he's just in the right place, right time.
He probably didn't want the attention either.
That too.
With all of this, you know, sort of being caught on camera, I can imagine that probably wasn't something he wanted people to see. However, it does send a message, like, you know, there are people that are paying attention that do care.
Yeah, you're right.
If they do say something, they do want to do something or say something.
Nobody really knows where to start.
Yeah.
A little Jon Bon Jovi trivia can I spurt out? His first album.
Talk to me.
Is that first album? Excuse me. His first recorded where he was singing. You'll never believe this. This is you can Google this as well. Was a Star Wars Christmas album that he recorded when he was 12 years old.
No
My
way.
Hand in the Heavens. Yeah, and he had his own single on it and everything. And then I always say about the Star Wars Christmas, but apparently Jesus went to another planet far, far away too.
Okay.
Because that's why we celebrate Christmas. Never understood that.
That video is one of the best movies you will ever watch is Star Wars Christmas. It's one of the worst, but it's one of the greatest.
And then there was a Muppet special, too, that they had Christmas specials with the Star Wars.
I remember I wanted the soundtrack to Star Wars, and what I got was a double album, which was the entire movie. Now, I wish to this day I still had that album, because it would probably be worth a fortune, but I was so irritated. All I wanted was the theme song. That's all I wanted. But instead I got the entire movie on two albums.
Another thing you guys missed in the 70s was the disco version of that song too. Remember that? Alright, we got all kinds of great stuff. Stick around. You are watching the Friday edition of Daily Flash, and we're so glad to have you here. Stick around.
Welcome back to Daily Flash. I'm Andrea Jackson. Stress over the economy, job security, elections, school violence, burnout, those are just a few of the issues Americans are facing on a daily basis. So how do you safeguard your mental health during these challenging times? Joining us to talk all about it is the author of Transforming Stigma, How to Become a Mental Wellness Superhero. He's mental health expert Mike Vini. Hi, Mike. Welcome to Daily Flash.
Hi, Andrea. How are you?
Very good. So what is your advice to Americans right now on how to safeguard their mental health?
It's important that people understand what self-care is. It's a term we hear a lot. And self-care is what you do for your health when you're not in the presence of a medical professional. That's it. And it's really important that we double down on that and we're intentional about it. And parents need to do that to be an example to their children.
So oftentimes, Mike, I think everybody has this. They've got a public persona and they've got a private persona. So how does someone pull themselves out of a mental health crisis if they're suffering from one personally?
That's a great question. And the key is you can't pull yourself out of a mental health crisis. We live in this world where we think we have to have all the answers. We're kind of taught that in school, actually, right? Know the answer, do the best you can. But when it comes to mental health, it's really important to let others in. So if you are struggling, whether you're in a crisis or just not in a crisis or just a little bit stressed, getting the help of a mental health professional is so important to help you along the journey.
Mike, you've got a personal connection to this. You faced significant challenges during your childhood, including expulsion from several schools. You even spent some time in psychiatric hospitals. How did those early experiences shape your approach to mental health and wellness today?
I know what it's like to struggle and what it's like to be in intense emotional pain. And I also know what it's like to be in a good spot mentally, which is where I'm at nowadays for the most part.
That's excellent to hear. Now, in your best-selling book, Transforming Stigma, How to Become a Mental Wellness Superhero, you explore the importance of breaking stigmas around mental health. What are those stigmas and how do we break them?
Well, sometimes it's a stereotype that we have in our minds about what someone with mental health struggles looks like. Prejudice is a feeling we get. Maybe we know someone in our life who struggles and we feel uncomfortable around them. And discrimination is behavior. We say, you know what, I'm not going to deal with someone or serve them a certain way because they're struggling with mental health. And the reality is, it's a part of life that we all experience in different ways. You can't see it. It doesn't look like anything. I mean, how many times do we hear about a celebrity dying by suicide and they look like they had it all together? They were smiling all the time. So it's really important to break down these ideas that we have in our mind about mental health and go talk about it loudly, get the help that we need.
You're also a corporate expert in this world. How does that work lend itself to your guidance?
Well, you know, we spend about one third of our day at least at work. And that's a place where mental health challenges come up. And if you're struggling with mental health challenges, you bring them to work with you. So it's really important that workplaces understand that this is going on with employees and have programs in place to support employees who are struggling. And what happens, it's a win for everyone. Employees get the help that they need. Workplaces are more productive and employees can bring that home again to their children, whatever they learn, to make them understand what it means mentally healthy.
Mike, thank you so much for your insight and sharing your story with us. For more information on safeguarding your mental health, check out Mike's book, Transforming Stigma, How to Become a Mental Wellness Superhero, and it's available at Amazon.com. Mitch?
Thank you, Jackson. Very good stuff there. Pop star Britney Spears has broken her silence following her recent MTV VMAs. Several pop stars actually paid tribute to the Baby One More Time hitmaker, including Sabrina Carpenter. Here's the 42-year-old pop star on her Instagram page. She admits she didn't watch the show, but caught clips on YouTube.
Okay, so did you guys watch the VMAs? I didn't watch the VMAs, but I did see stuff on my phone from YouTube of Sabrina Carpenter. Why is she kissing an alien on stage? I adore her. I love her to death. I didn't understand that part. Why didn't she kiss a girl? Like, that was weird. But I also thought that, like, the whole thing was kind of, like, weird altogether. But after that, after watching that, I took a really long bath. And I actually color. I'm into coloring right now. I like to color and I like to trace the pictures and then go back over it with light. Yeah, I just know why I'm talking about that or why I'm so. Oh, it's because this Sabrina girl, she said my name on the red carpet and I thought that was kind of cool.
Carpenter, along with Megan Thee Stallion and Tate McRae, all mentioned Spears during the award show. Obviously, you know, those cameras are not the best shot for, but she does, is not the Britney we know.
No, so, right? No, and it seems a little bit different. You can hear it in her voice. You can see it in her eyes. And even in the conversation she's having with the camera, it seems very disjointed.
Yeah.
And you want the best for her. You know, you understand she's been through so many struggles personally. You want her to win.
You want to, and at the same time, it's like you have to almost be, I don't want to call forceful, but like somebody needs to say, you've got to change, you know? And,
yeah.
But until they hit rock bottom, until they realize that change, that's the only time.
Yeah, and she's going to have to want the intervention if, you know, if that's the path she wants to go down or if she wants to stay on the current one that she's on.
Yeah, let's cross our fingers to hope that things will do better for her.
Absolutely.
For sure. Hey, we're going to be taking it to the movies. We'll be checking in with Tony Toscano coming up in just a little bit and Screen Chatter, all that and more coming up right here on Daily Flash. Don't you go anywhere. We have a website too, don't we?
We do, dailyflashshow.com.
Right.
And you know what? We even validate. Okay, come on.
Welcome back to Daily Flash. I'm Mitch Inglis. It's time for us to check in with Tony Toscano to find out what's coming out of Hollywood and straight to your screen, no matter what size you watch it on. With the latest, everybody, here's Tony!
Thanks, Mitch. Now in selected theaters is the romantic drama Take My Hand.
Have you had an episode like this before?
Your MRI shows areas of multiple sclerosis.
Laura, what's going on?
Broken face. I'm not getting any better.
I know, because I've had to go through this illness as well, Laura. Call before I hit the ground. Tell me I'm
safe, you've got me now. Based on a true story, a working mother of three is diagnosed with MS following the sudden death of her husband. When she moves back home to Australia, she has a chance encounter with her high school sweetheart, who gives her a renewed hope as she battles the disease.
I hope the takeaway that actually MS is not a death sentence. It's a life to carry on. You'll be okay. Just work hard at looking after yourself, taking care of yourself. And also take medication. I'm a big fan of that. I think people should be kind to each other.
It's nice to have a partner to help you to do these things too. So it helps you in every sort of way to have a loving partner. I mean, that's hard for MS patients as well, but, you know, we're just telling our side of the story.
Take My Hand is a wonderfully saccharine and heartfelt romance drama, perfect for an afternoon or evening without the kids. Again, it's in selected theaters and gets a B. It's not rated. Streaming on the Up Faith and Family TV network is the family drama, The Stones.
Do you have any idea what I would give to hear her voice just one more time?
A door appears in my closet. The same door that opened for me, it'll be there for you too. It leads to Central Dispatch.
McKenna Stewart, please report to Central Dispatch.
What? This is a dream, right?
People still need help, even though your mother is gone.
A young woman gets drawn into a supernatural system with Bible characters working undercover to help people today.
And it was a joy, you know, that it has a strong message. I really think it gives, you know, through the issues that get tackled in the episodes that are very difficult issues. You know, they really get into some gritty things that families will have to go through. I think the message of the show is hope, and that you're not alone, and that there is help. And so it's nice to be aligned with something so positive.
If you're looking for a well-written and heartwarming family series to watch, These Stones will fill that bill, as it's very reminiscent of Touched by an Angel and Highway to Heaven. Check it out now, streaming on the Up Faith and Family TV network. It gets a B and is not rated. For the Daily Flash, I'm film critic Tony Toscano.
So we can all relate to the challenges of adulthood when it comes to balancing work, life, and family. Here's reality star Jesse Solomon from Bravo's Summer House sharing his personal approach to maintaining a busy lifestyle.
How are you? Thanks for having me. National Adulting Day, it's a very special day for me. You know, I'm still learning how to be my best adult self, but OxiClean put this one on the calendar to celebrate, you know, different approaches to adulthood and really open up the discussion around what it means to be an adult. So I'm doing my best out here every day to be a good person, a good adult, to give back. I still work in finance. I've been making music. I just recorded a song in the studio last week. I'm putting out a holiday song. I have been back and forth to the Hamptons for 8 out of the last 9 weekends, and, you know, don't feel too bad for me. It's a fun time, but I've been very busy. I have a great team around me. I'm so blessed. I have a great manager. You know, I have a stylist now. Things are really changing. And she makes sure, I make sure that all my clothes are clean each week, especially with my my stains. I'm a walking stain. They call me Messy Jesse. I actually had a stain on a shirt that I hadn't even worn the other day. It still had the tags on it. So I took it home, used my OxiClean, and the stain came right out. So I gotta have my OxiClean handy, make sure I'm doing my laundry every week, I'm staying organized, I'm getting ahead of, you know, the events that I have, the clothes that I need, and just trying to stay on track. I'm just so excited to be an OxiClean partner and just share how these products have kind of enabled me to be my best adult self, even with my super busy schedule. So I'm grateful to be here. Thanks for having me, and stay clean.
All right, we still have more Daily Flash around the corner, but if you need your fix, don't worry. We got our website. It's up and running. It's dailyflashshow.com. There, anything you've seen on the show, you can see there. But more importantly, we love hearing from you.
Yes.
There's a little button you can click, sound off. Anything you have to say, we'd love to hear from you. We'll share it right here on the air on Daily Flash.
This is Daily Flash with your hosts, Andrea Jackson and Mitch English. Trending news and entertainment. This is Daily Flash.
Hey, everybody, I am Mitch English.
Yes, he is. I'm Andrea Jackson. This is Daily Flash, your source for trending news and entertainment. You're not going to get it anywhere else.
Listen,
I'm done.
And if you do, they're going to laugh at you.
You're shortchanging yourself.
They don't want you. You're shortchanging yourself as well. Listen, we've been doing this, as we mentioned yesterday, we've been doing this. This is our 8th season, and we are so happy to have you here for sure. We got a great show set up and ready to rock.
You like the cruise vacations,
yeah,
right?
We love the taking cruises. Sure, yeah.
So Royal Caribbean has just they've come out and they've said, look, no more of those multi-outlet plugs. You can no longer bring those on the cruises.
Okay, which is a big thing because people take Strip because there's only one plug in the thing.
Yes, okay. And I guess they've really put, they've cracked down on power strips and extension cords. Those technically aren't allowed in rooms, but people bring them in anyway. But now these multi-cord outlets, they're saying no more because they're a huge fire hazard.
Exactly.
Yeah, but people are upset because they're like, well, how am I supposed to plug in all my appliances?
And I think that does go to say something. I've been staying in some hotel rooms just as of late, and it's interesting that just when we got everybody to do the USB B or A rather, and now it's over to C.
Yeah.
And so I had to buy a bunch of little converters everywhere, but of course there's plugs and such.
Yeah.
And I think in the cruise lines, I can understand that, but I know if you go to like, when you go on maybe on your first cruise and you go and search on a website, they'll say, here's some little tips, some hacks. And they'll always say, bring a strip, a power strip.
Yeah.
So I could see that they need to do a crackdown
so
on that.
So just know that those will probably be confiscated on your way through security check-in.
Now, speaking of power strips, they're doing that over in the France, aren't
they?
Yes, they are, kind of.
A French museum announced that it will invite visitors to check out its latest exhibit on nature, wearing nothing but a pair of shoes.
Okay.
The museum will welcome naked patrons to show off their body of work on a certain day once a month. However, shoes will be required to avoid splinters from the floorboards. Don't slip and fall, that's all I'm saying. The new exhibit, which runs through December 9th, features paintings, sculptures, photographs, and moving images from nature.
And a lot of hairy armpits. Here's the thing. It's a way to get guys to go to the art museum. It's got to be, right?
I guess.
It's good to check out the nudes. Well, you're in.
Isn't that one big moving, you know, image from nature? If you're walking
100%,
around,
100%, like yes,
just swaying in the wind, and you know, from everybody's parts, and
bits and pieces.
You know what? Though the people that are going to get naked there aren't the people you want to see naked because they never are.
Go to any nudist beach, and that's the case.
The twigs and the berries
is something you don't want to see.
Yeah.
That's the other exhibit,
and no one wants to see art, or art's art, if you know what I mean. All right. Miami, let's head there now. It's known as the Magic City, losing a little bit of that sparkle.
Yeah.
And that, of course, is because, according to at least the residents who live there. In the latest study, Florida's hotspot has just named itself, basically, one of the rudest cities in the United States. Residents say there's no self-awareness. People are loud. They're rude. All to the service workers. A few dishonorable mentions as well. They don't respect personal space or hygiene in public and seem to lack any compassion for others. Get this. Nearly 90% of the residents that they survey say that people believe living in downtown Miami are not as nice as those living in the suburbs. Philadelphia, Tampa, Louisville. Well, they follow Miami in the rankings for cities with the rudest residents. The study says the nicest residents can be found in Omaha, Minneapolis, and San Diego. I was up in New York a while ago, but it's part of the charm that you have that. And as I like to go there thinking, listen, people are not going to help you. And then you wind up seeing people that do help you and you feel better about it. But it's interesting to see that Miami comes along with that.
At a McDonald's in Miami, I'm not kidding you, they had a security guard next to the fountain in the McDonald's because people would just come in, fill up, and leave. So they had their own lady standing there going, no soda.
No soda. That's it. We got trending news and entertainment heading your way. Don't go anywhere.
This is Tim. Tim is all about time. And if you've ever had a chance to look into Tim's cold, dead eyes, you'll see that it's time for you to follow us on social media. Sure, there's 10,000 social sites out there, and we don't have the time to name them all. Seriously, just ask Tim. So take the time to look for Daily Flash TV on your favorite social sites and start following us. That's all the time, Tim. Goodbye.
Hey, welcome back to Daily Flash. I'm Mitch English. When it comes to driving, we all share a common goal, arriving safe and sound to our destination. Joining us now, two high-performance drivers, Sabre Cook and Madeline Stewart, with some smart advice for navigating the roads.
As racing drivers, we are incredibly passionate about road safety. So we're really excited to share with you some tips on how to be safer on our roads. A key tip is to limit distractions. As drivers, we know how important it is to be incredibly focused so we minimize our mistakes. And that's the same on the road. A key tip is to limit your distractions inside your vehicle. We all know that cell phones can be a distraction while we're driving, so it's really important to put that to the side and specifically to turn off your notifications. We may have our phones to the side, but a lot of people are still tempted to check their phone should a message or a text come through. Turning off your notifications is going to reduce the temptation to look at your phone while driving. Another tip that we have is to reduce the volume of your sound system. It's really important as drivers that we maximize all of our senses around us, and hearing is a really important one. So turning down the volume on your stereo, whether it be music or radio, is going to help you to be focused on being able to hear what your vehicle is telling you and also hear your surrounds around you to make sure that you are capable of reacting to any situation that might come your way.
In the Porsche Carrera Cup series that we both race in, we utilize the ExxonMobil Synergy Supreme Plus fuel. And you guys can access the same exact fuel at almost 12,000 locations across the US. It's amazing because it's 3 times cleaner for your engine and also improves fuel economy, which we appreciate as much as everyone else, right, with gas prices. And with that confidence built up to know that your car is going to run on the best fuel and have no problems, it really gives you that calm and peace and allows you to focus your energy on being safe on the road and having no problems.
And just like it is important to fuel your vehicle, it's also important to fuel yourselves. So by being hydrated and eating all of the right foods, that's going to make sure that you are fueled for the length of your whole journey.
But the most important part is to always plan ahead. As racing drivers, we always know where the track's going to go before we get there, and we always have a plan for our weekend. So we encourage you, whether it's going to the grocery store or taking a long road trip, to definitely take a moment to go through each of your route guidelines so that way you know where you're going, especially if you happen to lose cell phone service and you don't have access to a map. But it also promotes removing that distraction of getting on your phone while you're driving. You can learn more about this fuel at Exxon.com and more about me at SaberCookRacing.com and for Madeline
at MadelineStewart.nz.
Thank you.
Millions of Americans will soon be making decisions about their Medicare coverage for next year. Joining us now to discuss what's new and what you need to know is Betsy Chin with United Healthcare.
The Medicare annual enrollment period runs each year from October 15th through December 7th. And this is a critical time of year for anybody on Medicare because it's your one chance to look at what's changing with your coverage for next year and to consider whether you want to enroll in a new plan. The things you should think about include your own personal health needs. So things like what doctors you see, what conditions you're managing, as well as any prescription drugs that you take. All of these are important factors when it comes to knowing what type of coverage that you'll need for next year. And the other thing I'd have you consider is your budget. Each type of Medicare coverage has different costs associated with it, whether that's a premium, deductibles, co-pays, or co-insurance. So considering both your health needs and your budget are critical factors to finding the right coverage for you. For more information, please visit MedicareEducation.com.
We love having you around. You know, a lot of people don't realize that we're actually in our eighth season. Jackson and I have been hosting together for over a decade, and we have so much fun here, don't we?
We do.
Sometimes too much
fun. We sort of finish each other's conversations. Jinx.
We'll be back.
The Department of Veterans Affairs is conducting the largest outreach campaign in its history, focused on bringing even more veterans to the VA to help with health and wellness. Joining us now with more is Adam Farina. Hi, Adam. Highlight some of the services you're providing to veterans.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me. When the PACT Act was signed into law by President Biden a couple years ago, he expanded health care and benefits to millions of veterans who have served our country from Vietnam, through all the way to today. And so we're doing everything we can to reach every one of those veterans and their survivors to encourage them to come to us. And that means come to us for healthcare, which is healthcare for all of your services, from pharmacy services to primary care appointments to mental health appointments, and then also disability compensation, which is monthly compensation for the conditions that followed our nation's veterans home from war. So we're doing everything we can to reach all those veterans and bring them to us.
How do you counter some of the negative perceptions of the VA?
This is not your grandmother's VA. It's not your grandfather's VA. In fact, VA healthcare is outperforming non-VA healthcare in just about every metric. And the metric that matters most to us is veteran trust. And in a recent survey of about 440,000 veterans reported trusting VA at 92%. That's not a statistic that exists in the private sector, and it's not something that you see in the private sector. And so we want those veterans to come to us because VA has changed, and that's what this outreach campaign is all about, showing that we're trying to build a VA where you don't have to come to us, where we will come to you and we will provide you with the care and benefits you've earned for your service to our country.
Adam, a terrific message. Thank you so much. For more information, please visit va.gov.
All right, good stuff there. Well, the cost of many prescriptions have actually gone up like so many other necessities, but there's a way that you can save money. Here's how.
60% of American adults depend on at least one prescription medication, and a quarter take four or more, all while facing increasing costs for these essential drugs.
BuzzRx offers a simple solution on saving money on prescription medications. Our free prescription discount service offers a solution on saving on prescription medications nationwide at over 60,000 pharmacies.
Visit BuzzRx.com to see how much you can save on your prescription medications.
Hey, September is Healthy Aging Month, and aging gracefully is more than adding years to your life, but making sure those years are more vibrant and fulfilling. Here to share proactive health management tips for healthy aging is Dr. Heidi Schwarzwald, Chief Medical Officer at Signify Health. Welcome, Doctor. So what are some of the challenges that aging seniors face when it comes to staying engaged in their healthy lifestyle?
Seniors face many challenges, including being alone and isolated. Many have trouble accessing a primary care provider, particularly if they live in rural areas. And that makes it hard for them to keep up with their health, understanding their numbers, as we say, their blood pressure, their glucose, their kidney health.
So what are the most important clinical tests or timely screenings that seniors should have or when they should have them?
Seniors should follow their blood pressure regularly. They should have their kidney health screened and their sugars or their glucose screened at least once a year, as well as actually screening for their cognitive health. Many times we don't notice as we have subtle changes in our memory and other types of cognitive health. All of these can be done by an in-home health assessment where a clinician comes to your home and does all of these screening tests at your convenience.
So how can seniors and their loved ones determine if they are eligible for IHE?
They can go to hellosignify.com or they can check the number on the back of their health insurance card to see if they're eligible. If you or your loved ones are eligible, these in-home evaluations are available at no cost to you. And all of this great information will be shared back with your primary care provider so you can continue to age in the most healthy way possible.
And where can we go for more information?
HelloSignify.com or again, calling your health insurance company to find out if you're eligible.
Thank you, Doctor. And we'll make sure we have this on our website at DailyFlashShow.com.
If you're in the market for a new home internet service, here's one to consider.
Get the best internet and save. With Verizon My Home, plans start as low as $35 a month. Get the Disney bundle, including Disney Plus, Hulu, and ESPN Plus for only $10 a month. And the price is guaranteed. No hidden fees, no equipment charges, and no unexpected price hikes. Check if Verizon Home Internet is available in your area at verizon.com/try5gHome. And if you qualify for a $150 Verizon gift card on us. It's like getting free 5G home internet for 3 months.
Hey, this is really cool, Jackson. Did you know that local farmers around the country are using the same cutting-edge smart technology to grow food and take care of their land? Here's more from local farmers Kaylee Howard and Nicole Spurlock.
Well, much like we use our smartphones to operate things in our house or, our cars are even smart these days, we're trying to make our farms as smart as possible. We also need to be efficient about it and embrace the technologies that allow us to do so. So one of those technologies is operating and managing our sprinkler irrigation systems. In our part of the country, we do need to irrigate our crops, but our smartphones allow us to tie into those sprinkler systems and know how much we're watering, whether we need to adjust that, turn it on and off, and that's super helpful.
So when you're talking about applying technology across a farm, it can get extremely costly. Programs like the NRCS help farmers understand what to buy and when to buy it and teach them how to use it. You can go to watergrows.org to learn how farmers across America are using their resources. And if you're more of a social media person, you can go to @watergrows and follow them there.
For 20 years, Ann Taylor and Loft have supported the Breast Cancer Research Foundation in their mission to explore new research to end breast cancer. Here with more is Lizanna Kindler with the Knitwell Group.
Well, I'm so excited to be here today to kick off our Sisterhood of Strength campaign in support of BCRF, the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. Part of the campaign this year, we brought in 20 thrivers to New York City and spent a day with them where we talked about their journey of living with breast cancer. And the point here is that these 20 women are thrivers today because of breast cancer research. By bringing together our amazing brands, Ann Taylor, Loft, White House Black Market, Chico, Soma, Talbots, Lane Bryant, we believe that we can reach the goal of $10 million. There are several ways that you can get involved, but most importantly, head to one of our stores. We've got 3,000 stores across the country, and all of our associates are ready to welcome you and talk about how you can support the cause. Go online to bcrf.org or knitwellgroup.com and inform yourself on how you can support the Sisterhood of Strength campaign.
Higher education, making some big changes, and one school is shining through it all. Check this out.
St. Norbert College is evolving with the needs of students and the changing workforce.
At the college, we are deeply committed to the intellectual, spiritual, and personal development of our students. Our education model is truly unique, focusing on the holistic development of each student, guiding them toward their true calling. We are also expanding our offerings to include new high-demand programs and certificates that meet the changing needs of students and the workforce.
For more, visit snc.edu.
Each year, National Coffee Day celebrates one of the most popular beverages in the world. Joining us today is Chef Dara Yu, who is teaming up with Versuni to share some brewing inspiration. Chef Yu was the season 12 winner of MasterChef. Welcome, Chef.
Thank you. Good morning.
So why is National Coffee Day so important to acknowledge?
Well, I'm not for sure if you know this, but coffee is the most consumed beverage after water. So I thought it was a good idea to talk about the evolution of that at-home culinary experience for America's favorite beverage.
Can you tell us about how technology has evolved to improve our morning cup of Java?
Yeah, I mean, it really is easier than ever to create cafe quality drinks at home, especially with like machines like the Philips Barista. You can create authentic espresso drinks with just a swipe, brew, and enjoy. And then create lattes and cappuccinos using the milk frother as well.
And how about for the coffee connoisseur? How fancy can you get with your in-home coffee maker?
Yeah, well, there's really a variety of machines for everyone out there. In addition to the Philips Barista, there's also machines like the Philips Barista Brew, which is a semi-automatic machine, as well as the Philips Full Auto, which you can create cafe quality drinks with just a push of a button.
That's great, Chef. But what have you been cooking up lately since winning MasterChef?
Yeah, I mean, I've been doing a ton of recipe development in home and been using machines like air fryers, things like the Philips Air Fryer 3000 uses this rapid air technology. So testing out, you know, recipes like chicken karage, which I know with an air fryer, especially with that rapid air technology, I can get that crisp outside and tender and juicy chicken on the inside. So it's been really fun to experiment.
Where can we go for more info?
Yep, you can go to home-appliances.philips to find more information.
Thanks, Chef. For more info, just head to our website, dailyflashshow.com.
Thanks, Maddie.
All right, now, speaking of coffee here, this woman right here is an angel. I'm going to brag on you. She remodeled her kitchen. It's amazing looking, but you got this really beautiful espresso machine. And I said, hey, well, what are you doing with the one you had? Can I buy it? She gave it to me. I'm telling you, the absolute, I call her, I go, you have no idea how great this coffee is. So thank you.
So happy. You all love right. it. Glad I went to a good home.
Thank you for sharing coffee with us and more. We'll see you tomorrow, or Monday.